Since the order of the events execution in our apps is so important, we're going to look at how you can initialize the controls that are added to a window, a screen, or a web page. So let's see how these events work. We're going to execute some simple projects on desktop, web, and mobile. We're going to focus on the opening, shown, closing, and closed events. So let's start with the desktop project. The UI has a label and a button. We added the opening event handler to the app object to every one of the controls added to the project UI and also to the window object itself. When we run this app, the messages area of the IDE will display a string when this event handler is called. So we can see here how the opening event has been called in the first place for the app object, then the opening event for the desktop label, the opening event on the desktop button, and lastly, the opening event on the by default window. The order in which the opening event is called on every one of the controls added to the window follows the same order used when adding them to the window in the layout editor. When looking at web projects, we need to consider the shown event in addition to the opening event handler. The shown event is applicable to any of the controls added to the web page and also to the web page itself. So we added both the opening and shown events to the label and button controls and to the default window, while both the app and session objects only require the opening event handler. As you can see, the code in every one of these events will print a string to the messages area of the IDE to let us know the order of their execution. So when we run the web app, we can see how the opening event is raised in the first place for the app object, followed by the opening event in the session object, the web label next, followed by the web button, and the opening event handler in the default web page. Once these have been raised, then the shown event will be raised for every one of the controls added to the by default web page, following the same order we used to add them to the web page in the layout editor, and finally, the shown event in the default web page itself. For mobile apps, in this case an iOS project, we follow the same pattern, adding the opening event handler for the app object to the mobile button and mobile label controls, and also to the default screen containing such controls. As we can see in the messages area, the opening event is raised first for the app object, followed by the opening call to every one of the controls added to the default screen, that is the label and button, and calling the opening event in the last place for the by default screen itself. As you can see, the order of execution of the opening event handlers follows the same order, no matter if it's a desktop, web, or mobile project. The order is also expected for the close or closing event handlers, so you can rely on that for the execution of the code you need to use in order to initialize the controls of the app, the window containing them, even the app object or the session object if it is a web project.